Hey everybody, Sexy Matt the Pharaoh Wizard here. So I thought it'd be interesting to do another worst to best list. Now last year I did Mission Impossible as like this franchise I really didn't have any interest in, but it has been going forever, so I finally decided to shotgun them. And I thought I'd try that again this year, and this time I went for the big end. The franchise I had absolutely no interest in whatsoever. I thought it was stupid. Don't know why it went so long. But you know what? I'm gonna dive into it head first. Let's do this. Fast and the Furious. Before this, I've never seen any Fast and the Furious stuff. I've seen trailers, I've been aware of its existence, obviously, but never once have I bothered to ever sit down and watch any of these movies. So I finally got them all down, watched them one a week for felt like forever. And let me tell you what I thought. So here is my worst to best list of Fast and the Furious from someone who's seen all these just once for the first time.
Number 9, The Fast and the Furious, Tokyo Drift.
Alright, so this one didn't seem as much as a sequel to Fast and the Furious as its cheap, like straight to DVD bargain bin version. And I think unless they didn't make the changes that they would eventually down the line, that's where they would have gone. This one is pretty dumb. It's not exactly the same as any other ones, but it's the whole fish out of water thing where Sean, which I'll tell you, I fucking hate Sean. He is the worst main character in any of these movies, and I'm glad he has not come back. Cross my fingers he doesn't show up in F9, but he is so bad. But yeah, he moves to Japan, and now he's this fish out of water, and he's got to learn how to race the way they do in Japan. And then he gets mixed up with drugs or some bullshit, I don't know. This one was really bad. The only saving grace was Han, which most people kind of know because he's the only one that went to any other movie. So yeah, this one's really bad. This is what I expected when I went into this franchise, this movie. And it's the worst, and I'm glad they moved on past it.
It's called drifting.
What do you mean, drift?
Number 8, Too Fast, Too Furious.
So the best thing going for Too Fast, Too Furious is its hilariously stupid name, but it's so fun to riff on. Because now you're just like, Too Captain, Too America. Or, you know, the next Mission Impossible, Too Mission, Too Possible. It's so fucking stupid. And the movie doesn't help at all. This is the one that introduces Tyrese, who's playing Roman, and I hate Roman, and he does pop up in other movies, and he's the worst. And this one gives Brian the most screen time. Of course, Paul Walker is the one who played Brian, and you know, elephant in the room, fortunately he did die, and that is sad, but I'm sorry, and I don't mean to dump on a dead person, but Paul Walker's a terrible actor, and he has been the worst part of this franchise going forward. He is the weight dragging them down, and it's only gotten better since he's not around. I'm sorry to say that, don't mean to speak ill of the dead, but it's kind of true. And this is proof of it. This is the one where he gets the most screen time. It's completely based around him. There is no Vin Diesel, there's no Dom, it's just Paul Walker and Roman, and it's a bad mix. I don't care for it.
He did the stare and drive on you, didn't he?
He got that from me.
Number 7, Fast and Furious.
So this one's kind of interesting and pretty fun at times, But what drags this one down the most and why it's so low on this list is it has the least personality out of all of them. Like, even Tokyo Drift, how bad it was, kind of had a personality. This one's pretty generic and pretty forgettable. Most people don't even remember this one. And it's fine. I like seeing Dom, played by Vin Diesel, going after revenge. That was kind of a fun thing. And this does have the crew. Mostly this one, the crew is just Dom and Brian, but it has them as bad guys, and I prefer them on the dark side of the law than where they become later in the franchise. But so that has it going for it. It has some really cool chase scenes, some really cool race scenes, but it's got a really ham-fisted street race fit in there. It's, like I said, it just doesn't have a whole lot of personality. It's pretty much a blank slate, and it just really didn't grab me.
You know each other?
He used to date my sister.
You're a lucky man.
How's that?
You're still breathing.
Number 6, The Fast and the Furious.
All right, so the good things about this one, it did set a lot in motion. It's not only this franchise, but there's a lot of action movies that came out trying to replicate this. It is its huge popularity. It inspired a whole new generation of like car people and car guys, and that's always really cool. I mean, it's not really my huge thing, but you know, if you're into that, that's awesome. And so it did some really cool stuff. It has some really amazing cars in it, but man, I mean, one, it's just Point Break. Like, it's the exact plot from Point Break. A, you know, officer of the law, either FBI or whatever, infiltrates a group that's doing some sort of extreme sport or extreme act who's also thieves. So it's just that, and it's got some really bad acting, and it's also got some really bad AVR. Like, the voices don't even match the people that they're trying to overdub the voices on. It's really bad, but it's also incredibly charming and kind of fun in that bad, dumb 2000s early era kind of action movie. So it's kind of fun dumb. It doesn't quite get to the lengths that it'll get eventually in the fun dumb area. And it gets a lot of points for, you know, kicking off a lot of things. But it is honestly still pretty bad. Seeing it through fresh eyes, never seeing it before in my life, this is, again, what I expected from this franchise. Maybe slightly better, but not much. It's still pretty bad, but not the worst thing ever.
What was that all about?
A business deal that went sour. Plus, I made the mistake of sleeping with his sister.
Number 5. Fast and Furious presents Hobbs and Shaw.
All right, from now on, now we have the stupid, ridiculous action version of Fast and the Furious. Pretty much from this point on, cars aren't the main focus. It's about doing big, stupid, dumb action, and tell you what, I'm here for it. So Hobbs and Shaw is the first spin-off that they're planning for this entire universe. There's a whole bunch of other spin-offs being planned, and maybe even a sequel to this one, and just stuff going on. So it's kind of the first expansion out of the main storyline, and I think they did a really good job. I mean, it's incredibly dumb. Like, the final scene switches from day to night constantly. Like, they didn't even bother noticing that. They just kind of went with it. But it's so dumb, you're just, that's cool. The goofy part of, with the cars all chaining up to pull down a helicopter was so dumb but fun. I was laughing so hard. I enjoyed it so much. And the action in this is actually super fantastic, which makes sense because it's by the director that also did Atomic Blonde, which is such a fantastic movie. So that guy knows how to do action, and it shows through in this one. Why it's so low is I kind of got a little tired of Hobbs and Shaw's pissing matches. Like, it was constantly like, I don't like you, I don't like you, you're British, you're giant. It just went like that way too much and way too long, and it started to grate on me a little bit. So that drops it down a lot for me. But it is stupid fun action, and I find myself relatively enjoying it.
If we stand a chance against Brixton,
You guys have to work together.
No way. This guy's a real ass.
Number 4. Fast and Furious 6.
Okay, so this is the first one where they are kind of the good guys. After the events of the previous one, they have been, you know, cleared of all charges and all that fun stuff. But now the crew has to team up against their first, like, big villain guy. Like, this is where it becomes, like, comic book ridiculous, where you have, like, a main bad guy villain. And that was really fun, and it had the whole soap opera-y thing where Letty, who is Dom's girlfriend who died back in the fourth one, is back, but she has amnesia. And you know what? I'm here for it. It's dumb, but it was kind of fun and great. There is some really great action scenes once again. This one focusing a bit more on some driving, but some really fun stuff. The downside of this one is the big bad villain. He's pretty generic, pretty bland. He does not stack up to what we see coming up in the next few movies. But you know, this one is big, dumb, fun action, and I enjoyed it.
How do I smell baby oil?
You keep running your pie hole, you're gonna smell an ass kicking.
You got
number 3, Furious 7.
So this is the final Paul Walker one, and I think they set him off in a pretty good way, because this is an incredibly dumb, fun action one as well. But this one fixes what I mentioned before, which is having a lack of a good villain. And this one, this is where we get Jason Statham, and he is great. I love Statham. He is a great action star, and I love seeing him brought into this franchise. And he is a great villain, something the team has to stack up against. On top of, they're trying to get Letty's memory back, trying to figure some stuff out. It has the amazing scene of a car driving out a skyscraper and into another skyscraper. Like, it's just big, dumb, ridiculous, and it was so fun. It was really awesome. Some of the downsides is it almost got too ridiculous at times. Like, this has the infamous scene of The Rock basically flexing out of a cast that he's been in. Also, having The Rock sidelined for most of the movies, which I'm sure in this one was due to scheduling or whatever, did kind of bum me out, because The Rock was a great addition. I'll get to that in a few movies down the line. So having him sidelined also kind of tripped it up a little, but it was, again, just big, dumb fun, way over the top, but with a great villain, so I highly enjoyed this one.
Hey, Terrell, you don't know me. You're about to.
Number 2, The Fate of the Furious.
So as I mentioned before, these kind of started slipping into like comic book levels of ridiculous. Like, these are basically superhero movies at this point. And of course, what do you do with a superhero? You make a good guy go bad. This is a movie where Dom, Vin Diesel, goes bad. And you find out why, but it's great. The best part of this one, though, is my girl, Charlize Theron. I love Charlize and everything she's in, and she is fantastic in this movie. She is just playing this villain that's super over the top, like cackling, ridiculous villain, and you can tell she's loving every freaking second of it, and it totally makes this movie. I really, really enjoyed this one a lot. There's a great scene in like some ice that was amazing. I don't know, this one I had a ton of fun with. Again, it was Charlize killing it, and just a lot of really big, dumb, fun action. I know I've been saying that a lot, but that's really the only way to do this kind of movie, is to know it's big, fun, dumb action, and just go with it and enjoy it, and this one really knows what to do with that.
Did you ever think you'd betray your family the way you did today?
Number 1, Fast 5.
And yes, the best Fast and the Furious. It's just in stone. Everyone knows it. Everyone loves it. This is the best Fast and the Furious. If you don't believe that, I'm sorry, but you're just wrong, because this is just the best one. I'm sorry. Because it has all the big, dumb action stuff that I mentioned before, but this is where we see The Rock as our adversary. He's not a bad guy. See, in this point in the franchise, the crew is still the bad guys. And that's actually where I love to see them. And this is a full-on hardcore heist movie. And that's where I really loved it. They had to steal a whole freaking safe. And it's just about getting the team together. Like, it's full-on super cheese heist movie everything. Like, everything that Rick and Morty episode was making fun of is in this episode. But it's so fantastic. And it's really the first team-up of everyone from the previous movies. You have Gal Gadot from Fast and Furious, the fourth one. Of course, you have Dom and Brian. You have Han from Tokyo Drift. You have Roman from Too Fast, Too Furious. Like, it's just the team-up of everyone for the first time, and it's so good. And like I said, it just had that extra level of them being the bad guy, and that's where I love to see this crew as the bad guys. In that scene with the safe being dragged by two cars through city streets is amazing. It is so funny. I loved it. It is so dumb, over the top, ridiculous, and I freaking loved it. It was so fun, so stupid. I loved it. And then, like I mentioned, this is the first appearance of The Rock in this franchise, and he definitely injected some new life into this franchise. If this movie wasn't the way this movie is, this franchise would be dead. The reason why we're getting F9 this year is because of Fast 5. And this also coined the term, like, 5 is where it gets good again. This is where this franchise turned on heel, decided to get away from the car stuff and just be big, dumb action. They couldn't focus on just street racing anymore. They know they had to go bigger and better and badder, and they did it, and they did it fantastically, and I loved it, and I'm all for it.
This just went from Mission Impossible to Mission of Freaking Sanity.
Let's stick to the plan.
So that is my ranking of Fast and the Furious from worst to best. And I gotta tell you, as someone that was sort of dreading this, kind of doing it as an experiment, you can tell I'm on board. I did not think I'd like these movies at all, but you know what? Once you get past those first three, if you can hammer through those ones, it's all downhill from there. It is gravy, it is fun, it's big, it's dumb, it's great action. I am all for it. I'm all hyped for F9. Like, how does Han come back? I'm so curious where we're gonna go with F9. They're planning even two more sequels, a sequel to Hobbs and Shaw, another spinoff. Like, they're planning a whole big thing, and I'm all for it. Let's get with Fast and Furious. I did not think I was gonna be a fan of this franchise at all, but you know what? I'm on board. I'm all for it. I love it. And I'm with it. So what is your second favorite Fast and the Furious movie? Because as we all know, Fast 5 is the best one. But what's your second favorite? Let me know in those comments below. Hit that thumbs up. Let me know if there's another franchise you want me to tackle, because there's a lot I haven't seen all of them of, or I just avoid that franchise. And I thought this was a very fun, interesting experiment to try. Just dive into a franchise and see what it's like. And I quite enjoyed it. So I'm Sexy Matt the Pharaoh Wizard. Until next time, hold on to your Holtzlots.